ओम ज्ञानतिमिरन्दस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुर्मिलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरुभे नमः। नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वते देवी गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषाय शून्यवादि पाशाददेशतारिणे। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासदि गौरभक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। सो हियर इज द पास्ट टाइम लॉर्ड चैतन्य एंड ब्रीफ दैट दे ट्राई टू मेक चैतन्य महाप्रभु यूज्ड टू लाई ऑन द फ्लोर एंड ही वाज वेरी थिन। And you know, any thin person lies on the floor, it is painful, the bones, that. The devotees made a bed, soft, they put some cushion and all, and brought it in front of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu rejected it. In fact, he was very scared when he came to know Jagadananda, because Jagadananda is Satyabhama and Krishna Leela. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu comes as his mood was like Satyabhama. Always, so many things, there is one pastor. Once he makes an oil for Lord Chaitanya. Very, the oil which he offered to the deities. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, I cannot use this. He broke the bottle in front of him in anger. So always that mood was there. Just like Satyabhama and Krishna, Rukmini Krishna, relationship is different. Rukmini will never get angry. Always accept whatever Krishna says. And Satyabhama will always be fighting. That is the nature. This is the fan on. It's hot. So anyway, so here the bed was made by Jagadananda because, no, switch on the fan, not off. Even my fan you switch on, that's all I said. Take care. So now this is the situation and it is very hot. We don't have any austerity. You see the austerity. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu refused. And then Jagadananda, what he did was at Saru Damodar, he took banana leaves and you collected some banana leaves and by cutting them and all made some kind of a bed. I said, please accept. It is painful for us to see you lying on the floor. Now, what do we take from this for us? We cannot imitate the austerities of Lord Chaitanya. Prabhupada does not. But let us understand the principle. The principle is this, that a devotee is focused on Krishna's comforts. And a karmi is focused on his comforts. That is how you differentiate a devotee from a karmi. Devotee is always meditating how to keep Krishna comfortable. I should do this for the Lord, I should get this for the Lord, I should cook this for that. His focus is on Krishna's comfort. So the devotees of Lord Chaitanya are not wrong because they knew his Krishna. And therefore, they were not able to ever stand his austerity. They are all gopis. Actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pastime is Krishna surrounded by gopis. But Krishna is acting like his devotee. So when he is giving example of a devotee, he likes to follow the austerities we should follow. But his intimate devotees will not stand that. You got it? Suppose Krishna comes to your home and instead of sitting on the chair, he sits on the floor. You as a devotee want to offer him comforts. Correct? That is me. That is the definition of a devotee. But Krishna, suppose it doesn't take, you feel pain. He's not accepting some service. Suppose somebody comes to your house, a respectable person, you give him a glass of water. I don't want. At least please accept some service, like to offer service. So they are devotee means they want to serve Krishna. At the same time, the contradiction is coming because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has taken the role of a devotee. He's Krishna. But he's in the role of a devotee. So therefore, these duos always went on. Therefore, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to South Indian tour, he wanted to give an example of an ideal sannyasi. He did not bring any of his devotees with him because he knows they will not allow him to do the austerities. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to be eating, he used to give me some boiled vegetable. As a sannyasi, he should take a simple food. But they will bring all, Jagannatha Prasadam. He was in Jagannath Puri and they give all cakes, you know, not our bakery cakes, no? Nobody eats that in Vedic culture. It's made of maida. Maida is poison. They will make, you know, like made of sweets, some like whatever. They will give a lot of rich items to eat. And they keep on the plate. And Chitranabu, if he says no, they don't eat for, they fast for a few days. That was the relation. They'll get so upset, they'll not eat for a few days. Chitranabu used to say, okay. So that was like, but anyway, even within this pastime, there is a lesson for all of us that our focus should not be on our comfort. Our focus should be on Krishna's comfort. Prabhupada used to sometimes say, you keep Krishna comfortable, he will keep you comfortable. And that is true. Prabhupada, as the movement was growing all around the world, and you know, so much opulence came to the movement, Prabhupada said, because you people are trying to keep Krishna comfortable, he is sending you back. It's always a reciprocation. You dress Krishna, Krishna is as a person. Krishna also feels, he's not wearing good dress. I should arrange a good dress for him. Somebody will come to the temple and give this address, please. So that is how the reciprocation Krishna arranges. You give him anything, he will reciprocate. Not only one life, many lifetimes you will be thinking. And he is the greatest personality. Small personality means you give him a mountain, he will forget. And he will say, what you have done? And you know Krishna Sudama. Sudama offered nothing to Krishna. But Krishna practically gave him everything. Opulence of an Indra. So therefore, who will not serve Krishna? So we should be absorbed. That is a devotee. We should be absorbed. Therefore, we have to. Mind means to expand. Today I have this mobile, tomorrow I should have that mobile. Mind is always expanding in those two ways. Instead of that, we expand for Krishna. Today I offer to Krishna this. Why we cannot offer this to Krishna? Why not offer a very good kirtan to Krishna? Most pleasing thing to Krishna is kirtan. Correct? We can offer that. And we can offer different ways. Our whole absorption should be on offering service to Krishna. As for personal self, now these austerities which Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has done, it is not possible for us. We will not even chant Hare Krishna after that. And there are terrible austerities which he personally used to practice. We follow the orders given by the Acharya, Srila Prabhupada, the disciple of Lord Chaitanya has given orders. We should not, Prabhupada says, imitate a great personality. We should follow. Correct? We should not try to imitate the austerities even taken by Srila Prabhupada to launch his movement. Prabhupada used to sit in his room. He did not have anything. Just one trunk he had. In Radha Damodar temple, only thing Srila Prabhupada had one trunk. In that he was writing, not even a table. In that he was writing all his, you know, the work was going on. Basically the point is that acharyas take terrible austerities in service to the Lord. We should not try to imitate that. We try to follow their orders. That is good for us. Correct? And the orders of the Acharya is that simple living, high thinking. Today people's life is high living, no thinking. High living, you know, this I should have, this I should have. Actually they buy things which they don't need, mostly. High living and no thinking. But actually the guidance of the Shastra is simple living, high thinking. So we save our time from so many ways and we can nurture our Krishna consciousness. You see, today I was showing one book and we really, my God, I have not seen this book. So our focus should be the so much nectar the Acharya has given in so many books. Why I am so unfortunate that I cannot read them? Just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says. What does he say? He says, there is so much nectar in the holy name, but I am so unfortunate. I don't have any taste of chanting your names. Similarly, the Acharya Prabhupada has given so many wonderful books, and I am so unfortunate, I have no taste of reading them. That is my misfortune. Kaliyuga, people are very unfortunate. What does it say? I quote some shlokas now. Kalo asmini yuge juna. What is the nature of the? Manda sumanda matayo manda bhagya upadirta. They are dull-headed, they have no intelligence, and they are very unfortunate. Yes, so actually we are very unfortunate. Just by chanting Hare Krishna, reading Prabhupada books, we can go back to Krishna, but we will not do that. We will not chant Hare Krishna, we will not read the Acharya's book. And here Acharya is sitting, who could make people every part of the world devotee of Krishna, such a great Acharya. But we have no attraction to hear his words. No interest, no attraction. That is our misfortune. Durbhagya. Correct? In front of us, such a great opportunity to take association of such an exalted personality, but you have no interest. That is nothing, our misfortune. Like suppose, somebody is born in a very rich, opulent family, it's all opportunity, but he doesn't take advantage of it. What do you say? Unfortunate. Somebody is studying in a very nice college. He can become a wonderful doctor. And he finishes, there are some students here, they call them bhaiyas, they finish medicine in 10 years. Why? The father has a clinic. He knows he has to just finish and join the clinic. He doesn't have to do anything. A roaring practice is there. But idle mind, devil's workshop, all anarthas are there. He cannot pass a single course. 10 years, 12 years they take to pass. Finally, they simply pass him. You know, he simply wants a degree. They get fed up the teacher. They tell each other, pass him. You know, 10, 12 years. So it's like that. What do you call that person? Unfortunate. Such a nice opportunity. So similarly, human form of life, what an opportunity it is to go back to Krishna's lotus feet. But we are wasting our time. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is giving a principle. We should, as far as possible, we should live a simple life. Keep ourselves away from artificial necessities. Take it? That is the principle of actually every religion. Every religion teaches this basic principle. Life should be simple. Take it? And we save time for God realization. Actually, a lot of time is wasted. There are so many things which we can save. And this is an example. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to give an example. We should not try to imitate that. As far as possible, yes. Nirbandha Krishna Sambandhe Yukta Vairagya Uchite. We engage things in Krishna service. Well, the name of engagement in Krishna service, people do anything and everything. Therefore, example is there. No, for Krishna service, I will have something. I will have a golden all vessels. I will eat on golden vessels. I am eating Krishna prasadam in that. Possible, you can, that people can misuse, so therefore an example is there. See how the Lord himself as a devotee has given an example. You can't go till that much, but at least go near that. Go near that. And overall life, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very, very, very austere. Very austere. And this should be a principle in our life. Srila Prabhupada ki.